this society, they gonna have a way to use us. And I keep saying us because we not separate from you. And if we not separate from you, we gotta care about you. And if we care about you, we gotta speak real and listen. We gotta speak real, but we gotta listen. And please, men, don't sit down. Stand up and be around where any kind of communication is going on. Don't sit down, men. Those who came to Hip Hop Detox don't have a seat. We didn't come here to sit down.
I'm your brother. I gotta be honest with you. They tapping our phones. They checking us out on Facebook and Twitter. Why would you even say something about going to Ridge Mall when all the white people at Ridge Mall, they don't care about putting order on anybody, but especially some of us who think we gonna make an example out of Ridge Mall like we did Ford City Mall. Understand this, I'm not putting myself in that we, but when it comes to us, some people don't care about this. All they say is they all look alike. We gonna go out and turn up, police turn up, and then people who not police turn up because they trying to protect the power. So everybody in here, this ain't gonna be no regular session.
War. I'ma say it again. Now, I don't mind coming down or up to sit and be with any of my guys. Because in this world, if you want peace, you gotta be willing to go to war first. I'ma say it again. If you want peace, you gotta be willing to fight for peace. I don't care if it's at home, I don't care if it's at school, I don't care if it's in yourself. You gotta be willing to deal with you. So everybody, when I say peace, I'm not just talking about throwing up the deuces. This is how we break peace down. On the count of three, everybody in a real slow beat, like a real slow beat. Say what peace means. One, two, three.
Who you know if they knew you was homeless, you got kicked out of the house, and you didn't have no place to stay, they wouldn't even help. And they supposed to be your boy. They supposed to be your homie. Some of y'all got guys like that. Let me say this to you all, and I want to be very honest, because some of y'all know about this. I know guys who did dirt, and as soon as they went down to jail, not only did they guys outside not help with a lawyer, not help with bail, but they didn't even know them. How many of y'all know people like that?
I want them.
They leave your ass naked. They don't do a damn thing, but when you was talking and you was setting up the plan, they was telling you, yeah, dude, we gonna do this, you know what I'm saying? We gonna get that. And as soon as somebody get caught up, they don't know your ass no more. They don't take no collect call. They not trying to, oh yeah, they listen to your girl too, yeah. Because you got people who say they real brothers, but they ain't your real brother. They real with you as long as things are good. Check this out. If I go for my brother, I want you to see who you got coming to your school, because some of you all, we could be working with you all right now on different levels, but see, you scared because you keep listening to dudes talking about what they gonna do, what they gonna do. But you got people that's doing it right now that's coming to your school saying, hey, if you want to get down, let's do something. But some of y'all bullshit because y'all still thinking that the same talk and the big stuff that you think you're doing, man, there's some things that's a little bit bigger than that. Some things that, you know, if I walk these bricks before you, and a couple of these men around here, they done walked the bricks before you, don't you think that, damn, they might know something that can help if they truly your brother? Now, some people ain't gonna be brother, they ain't gonna lie to you. Some people don't know how to be a brother, so they ain't gonna try to help you. All they gonna do is talk, and some people don't talk. They don't do nothing but look at you and watch you fall. Now, some of you all, if what I'm saying is true, if y'all think that I'm being real with you, just say true. Now, to those who think it's true, I wanna say this to you. This right here is what brothers want. What word is that, y'all? What word is that, y'all? Say it like me, and what word is that? Check this out. Say it with your chest, say it with your chest. Let me ask you all a question. If you say you want justice, justice means that you gonna guarantee that no one that you consider a brother is what? Mistreated, and the one who is most in need of help gets the. Let me ask y'all a question then. Why is it that some of y'all got boys, you know they can't even read past the second grade level, and y'all ass just laugh at it? Dude be in the damn grocery store talking about, is that a can of chicken? You know that ain't nothing some damn lard and Crisco. And you know the dude can't read, and he think it's some damn chicken in the damn can. Ain't no damn chicken in the can. He think it's some damn potato chips and got some damn ribs on it. He think it's some damn real ribs in a damn Ruffles bag. That's just barbecue flavor potato chips. And you all laugh at your guy knowing that he can't read. But if you a true brother, won't a true brother help and say, look here, man, I know somebody that can help you to read if I can't help you. Check this out, y'all. Check this out. True story. When you all go to Google, and y'all go to Google, Freeway Rick Ross, when I brought him to Chicago after he got the pen back in 2009, I brought him to Chicago, I brought him to Jupiter. I don't know if any of y'all probably weren't here when I brought him to Jupiter. But check this out. When I brought him here, he told everybody that with all the millions that he was making, serving, after the government took his money away, pay attention, fam. When the government took his money away and the lawyers took his money, he said that when they were about to give him a life sentence in the penitentiary, his lawyer said, I can't care more about your case than you care. He said, you don't even know how to read. So how are you gonna get upset with me because they just gave you a life sentence? He was 28 and didn't know how to read. He had to humble himself and let his celly teach him how to read because they was trying to earth slam him with life imprisonment. Because he took the time to study his own case, and some of you all, please don't have disrespectful things going on while I'm talking. Because his celly had to teach him how to read, one of the things that took place was is that he didn't get that life sentence. I'm doing it as a brother. How many of y'all looked at your urine and you saw your urine was purple or green or dark green or it smelled like ammonia or something? Now check this out. I'm not talking about if you got gonorrhea, man. If it's painful like that, that ain't no, that's different. That means that, you know, you got something else going on, you need a shot. But if you talking about regular urinating and your urine is different colors like that, your urine is supposed to be clear. Even when you use the bathroom, if it's a dark yellow after you eat, that's cool. But if 2-3 days later you get dark green every time you use the bathroom, what that means is that there's something going on in your body. If you are a kind of person where you wear boxers and they different colors, blue, brown, green, whatever kind of color boxer, but when you use the bathroom and you do the number two, y'all know what I mean by the number two. When you do that, but then you don't use the tissue and you don't wet the tissue, then that means you got black ice in your drawers. Y'all know what the hell black ice is in your damn drawers? Because if you wore white, you see them damn tire tracks on your damn drawers. But when you wear colored drawers, you don't see them.
still goddamn black ice. And you running around, people like, damn, something stinks, smell like shit in here. But what is that? It smells hot. But the reason why it smells hot is because nobody told you that when you use the bathroom, don't just use dry tissue in your butt. You gotta wipe that damn tissue, damn it a little bit, and then wipe it off. And then take some dry tissue, and then wipe it some more. Because if you don't do that, you gonna walk around, you playing basketball like, damn, something smell around here. Yeah! Because nobody told you. Y'all think I'm playing. Now I know, because right now, everybody thinks, oh man, you know, if you ain't talking about this, you ain't, I can't hear you. And unfortunately, most people don't realize that until they end up incarcerated, and they say, damn, I wanna be saved now, like Chief Keef wanna be a Christian now. 1.2 million. So because they didn't get their money back, they say, yo, we gonna do a little free Chief Keef, we gonna do something, because we want our investment back and the money that we invested back. We gonna find a way to get our money. Anybody knows, again, don't take what I'm saying for face value. All you gotta do is look stuff on the internet, because the reality is that it was a setup move, because they was hoping that with the mistakes he was making, they can use his mistakes to make money. I'm your brother. The people you're gonna be talking to and talking with, we your brother. But damn, I gotta climb over a damn seat or sit next to some of you all to make you feel it, bro. To make you recognize that we ain't talking no bull up in there. Do somebody gotta tell you, damn, man, you know what? If we care about you, the only reason why we're here is because we truly want to say something to you. We sat in these seats. I was one of those who lost one of my friends. Popped off fresh on sophomore year that popped off. He was such a badass as a vice lord that he went to the wrong school to rob somebody and he got his brains blown out. Or some of my GD friends. Or some of my BD friends. A lot of times people forget that you not starting nothing new here. I'm not looking at nobody in particular. But if I keep seeing somebody back turn the opposite way, it makes me to think that, damn, maybe I'm saying something wrong. I'll get a microphone one of y'all. Maybe I'm wrong. Go ahead, sir. The reason why I'm doing this, fam, not just because this is going to be shown, you know, he videotaped, not because of that. I'm doing this because I made the mistakes already. I'm happy to be alive, but my happiness means nothing if my people don't get better. I'm getting tired of seeing everybody look at us on damn YouTube talking about Chicago this, Chicago.